I uploaded this video yesterday, 1 March 2013, and I was interested in the question whether this circuit is also usable for higher frequencies, so not only for audio. For audio, generally spoken, this capacitor has to be 10 microfarad, input cap also 10 microfarad, output cap also 10 microfarad, but the whole circuit is very universal, and that means that this circuit can work up to 30 megahertz or even more. Of course, when you use a suitable transistor, this is the BC547B, I've tested it many times, it works up to approximately 8 megahertz. Again, this is the same circuit that I've showed earlier, but now there are a few adaptations. I test it now on frequencies between 2 and 10 megahertz. Does it amplify? That's the question. And the input cap is now lower to a very low value. I've used 1 nanofarad, so 1000 picofarad here, 1000 picofarad here, and also here this capacitor is now 1000 picofarad. 1000 picofarad, 1 nanofarad. And I want to demonstrate now what happens. This is my signal generator. It can make frequencies between 2 megahertz and 10 megahertz. It's now set to 10 megahertz maximum. And this is the amplified signal. I move now the probe from my scope to the input. This is the signal at the input from this amplifier, and this is the signal at the output. So you see it amplifies substantially. But when I take out the emitter capacitor with a switch, it doesn't amplify any longer. And that's the crucial issue in this circuit. This emitter capacitor sets the frequency band, makes the whole circuit work properly or best on a certain frequency band, and in this case that's 10 megahertz. I want to show now what happens when we change the frequency at the input from this circuit. This is 10 megahertz, and I go back now to lower frequency, and that is 6 megahertz. Again, back to lower frequencies, approximately 4 megahertz. Back to lower frequencies, approximately 2 megahertz. And you can also see that the waveform changes, and that all has to do with the base potentiometer here in the circuit, this one. So you have to adapt the base potentiometer somewhat to get a better waveform. So it doesn't stay, it is not very perfect, but it's better, and that has also to do with the fact that I made this generator myself, and the sine wave is not perfect. So when you put a not perfect signal in, you get a not perfect signal out when you amplify it, of course. Okay, so that's what I wanted to point out in this video. The circuit is also usable for higher frequencies, and when you use a typical high frequency transistor, in the European system, this is a BF transistor, you'll see that you can amplify frequencies from, let's say, 50 megahertz or so, or perhaps even more.